I wanted to talk about what is the best tree stand that you could use on your private land. Now, this is a completely different discussion, and there's a little bit of overlap, but it's a completely different discussion for what kind of a tree stand you can use on public land or should be using on public land. Now, public land is more run and gun, it's more mobile, and so there's different types of tree stands for that. But when you try to apply those mobile type tree stands on a private land parcel, a lot of times there's too much noise, too much scent left behind when you're actually applying those run and gun techniques to a private land parcel. Let's face it, most of us don't have thousands of acres of private land to work with. So whether it's 300, 100, 50, or 5 acres, you still have to maximize your locations. You can't afford to burn out locations. And a good stand on private land to me has to allow me to shoot in a lot of different directions, maybe 270 degrees with barely shifting. It has to be completely quiet, has to be easy to get into, big and comfortable. Because I'm setting these stands up months in advance, several months in advance a lot of times, and I'm leaving through them throughout the season. So I expect them to not only be comfortable, quiet, but I expect them to be safe and easy to get into as well. So let's talk about a couple different options. First of all, and I'll tell you what I think is the best combination, but first of all, let's say type a tree sling type seat where you're sitting up in a tree. Well, that's okay for run and gun, but when you have private land and I want to be able to shoot in at least 180 degrees while I'm seated in this location without moving, and then by standing I want to be able to shoot behind me very quietly and easy with no noise, I can't afford to move and bring a bow back around a tree. If I can stand and shoot to the right, you can find with a fixed position tree stand, you can get about 270 degrees of very quick and quiet shooting, and I demand that. So at the same time, when I get to my tree stand, I want to be able to climb directly up. I can't afford to put anything on. I don't want to change clothes at that point. If I'm changing clothes, it's up in the stand or putting something on, because then I'm just leaving a big scent wick down below from changing clothes, putting on a harness, getting up in that tree. I want to just be able to get to my tree and go up. It's almost a panicked feeling. I work 35 minutes to sneak into that stand. You're stalking that tree stand. Then all of a sudden you make this big mess of noise and zippers and snaps and commotion. It's not appropriate for a private land stand the majority of the time, unless you're sharing it with other people. You don't want them to use your stands. There's always that exception. But I can guarantee you this, no one will be allowed on my land to use that type of tree stand, and it has nothing to do with a sponsorship or a partnership with anybody. It's just I don't want them destroying my hunt, let alone their hunt, let alone the portions of land that a poor fit tree stand would be included on private land. Now, climbers, kind of the same idea. I use a climber on public land. I like that. If there were twisted, poor trees where I hunted on public land, I'd probably opt for some type of tree saddle, tree seat, whatever way you want to call it. I'd probably opt for something like that with twisted, poorly formed trees. And it might be that I'd use a pop-up or something that's a ground blind too. So there's a lot of different options for run and gun on public land. I've even used lightweight stands, lightweight sticks, something like that. I think a tree saddle is more comfortable at that point. But I use a climber a lot because I'm hunting big open hardwoods, especially some of the remote areas of Ohio I've hunted, or Pennsylvania on public land. And that climber seems to be a great choice, but a climber is very poor choice for private land. Look at it with public land. I might walk in an hour and a half and then climb up a ladder, with a climber, get into a tree. For that, I get 20, 25 feet up, which is what I like if I'm out on public land and I'm in open hardwoods. You gotta get a lot higher in open hardwoods than you do in some type of low brush country. So I'm hunting a lot of ridges, hills, benches, saddles. And so that means getting up high and making sure the deer can't see me. So a climber is a great, safe way to do that. But at the same time, it's noisy. I expect when I go back into a location like that, that because of just having to put it together and inch up the tree, I can be pretty quiet with it, but I'm not gonna sneak up on a buck that's 100 yards away while I'm going up in a climber like I demand in private land. You know, you don't have a lot of acres to work with. I have bedding areas right over there, just 100 yards over and down the ridge there, where if I'm getting into a noisy stand and there's a banging or a clang, then I'm not going to shoot that deer. There's many times where I've actually gone into a stand. I pulled my bow up, I hit something metal on the way up. I actually get down and change stands because I made that little noise. And a lot of people with a climber and some cheap stands, they're making that amount of noise every time out in the woods. I couldn't handle that. I can't, that's why I don't like zippers and Velcro and everything else. I don't want to make a lot of noise when I'm in the tree. You got to blend. I always think, and I've obviously, it goes back to it. This is, you know, kind of an extreme example, but always view the deer as if they had guns and they're going to fire back. They're waiting for you to come in the woods. They're ambushing you. Well, you're not going to hunt. Most people wouldn't hunt the same way. And I'm not talking about you wouldn't hunt because they have guns. I'm just saying, you think about that. How would you hunt different if the deer actually had guns? You wouldn't use noisy stands. You probably wouldn't use a climber on private land when the enemy's just around the corner, behind some thick brush or down a little ridge system. You'd be quiet getting in and out. And that's what I demand for hunting. And I want to be able to shoot in all those different directions. So for me, some type of tree seat, a climber, not really appropriate. Then it comes down to a fixed position stand like you see behind me and above me. And then also ladder stands. And now ladder stand, a lot of my clients use ladders, I would say 50%. And it's a safe way to hunt. They have various family members that are young and old. It's very easy for them to get into the tree. And what I don't like about ladders is a lot of times I'm sneaking to that tree. I'm stalking that tree. I'm getting, the closer I get to that tree, the slower I'm going. I want to get to that tree and then quietly go up the tree as fast as possible. I want to go up the back side of the tree. So if I think deer are on the opposite side, which is where I'm facing, where I'm hunting, then I want to go up the back side of the tree and I want to position myself with a large tree, whatever tree I'm using for the stand, to be between myself and where I expect the deer to be. So that's very important. So I'm going up the back side and then I would just step around 90 to 100 degree, 120 degrees and stand on that stand, that fixed position stand. And even then, as I'm climbing up and I see deer bedded down 50 yards away, I can be very quiet, I can go very slow, and I can just inch my way up and settle and move around in that stand and sneak into that tree. I've gone up and down many times like that without spooking deer. You can't do that with a ladder stand because the ladder is on the opposite side of the tree. You have to climb up with your back exposed to the deer. But a lot of times it's a necessary evil because it's easy to climb into and it's safe. It's safe for a lot of different experience levels for hunters. But I can tell you, with the stands we use, the family tradition, this is something that's a little bit different. This type of ladder is expensive. It's a 20-foot ladder from family traditions. And it's not the typical $40 to $50, 20 to 25 foot ladder that you find at the big box stores. It's solid. You can actually bend it just about to the contour of the tree. It's rolled steel. It's USA steel. It's US steel, but purchased from US steel. Another thing with this, it's a little bit wider than a lot of the big box store types of stands. And then the footrest. You can see my foot right here. These are size 10s. Not huge, but imagine like a big boot. I have more than enough room to climb all the way up this. Now then we add a safety line here, the Hunter safety line. This is on us too. So before we leave the ground, we're hooked in. So we're hooked in our safety vest. So all I have to do is my lanyard is hanging out, my strap is hanging out the back of my clothing right here, out through my first light. I just take it, hook it, and I climb immediately up after hanging my bow from my bow rope right here. So very easy process. What I like with this as a compromise for a ladder stand is this is a very easy big ladder to climb. It's very safe. It's not going to move. It's steel. It's very strong. Instead of $40, $50, this is close to $200 for this ladder. So it's expensive, but it's meant to last for decades, not meant to last for a few years and then you throw it away. The stand itself, very large. That stand up there has a welded on footrest, has a 14 by 20 web seat. The platform is held up by chain and rubber coated chain. It has a T-screw that screws into the tree. You can set the stand on it and then two 800 pound ratchet straps. Everything about the stand and ladder is extremely safe. So as opposed to the $50 cheap box store ladder and some of the put together tree stands that cost $60, $70, this is a lot better alternative. And what I like is, again, I can climb up the back of the stand, I can step around, so if I think deer are down there, which is where I expect them to come from, I can sneak in from behind this tree right here, and then I just step over slowly to the actual stand itself. That's a good alternative. So I like ladder stands. I really like a fixed position like this. It's set in place and something we can get in and easy, safely, easy in and out. And so to me, my favorite stand for private land would be this type of combination where you have a quality ladder and a quality stand with a safety line to allow you to get in and out with your lifeline so that you can stay safe before you even leave the ground. And then that close second would be a ladder stand. We have ladder stands in locations where it's a poorly formed tree, the smaller tree, but we have that ability to get that ladder stand in there. And we have ladder stands, our family tradition ladder stands situated around this property, and I really like them. But there's something about being able to go up the back of this tree, stay hidden, and safely get into the tree. And that's why on private land, I hunt fixed position stands. I strongly encourage you to do so. Strongly encourage you to use something of high quality that allows you to sneak into the tree. That next best thing is that ladder stand. And again, a lot of people use those because it applies to a lot of people. But again, it's fixed position. You can get in quietly. You're just going right up the tree. I still encourage you to use a safety line, even if it's a ladder stand. I see a lot of people that don't on ladder stands because they say, well, it's a ladder stand, I don't have to use one, and easier to get in and out. But you always have to use a safety line when you step off the ground. And I'll add one other safety factor again. When I'm putting this ladder up, I expect that stand to be 90 to 120 degrees around the tree so I can easily step over to it. I've seen stands where you go up that 20 feet and then the stand is 2 feet above that point and on the opposite side of the tree, and you're shimming and trying to hold, and very unsafe. So we're using that 90 to 120 degree rule. We're just stepping around. I like climbing up the back of a tree. I'm using something solid, extremely quiet. What you'll find is pretty interesting. When you find a safe quality stand, they're usually very, well, they're gonna last, but then at the same time, they're very quiet because well-made products are very quiet, not squeaky, they're not thin, they're not gonna break over time, cables and thin metal, thin steel. So, completely different than what I would use on public land, and it really is. Like I said, I use climbers on public land a lot. I have the perfect trees to do so in Pennsylvania and Ohio where I like to hit. And I'm actually using ground blinds a lot in the UP of Michigan where I'm hunting those low swamp ground and brush. I want to see under the pine boughs and spruce boughs. As soon as I get in the air, you can't see a thing. So a lot of times I'm sitting down on the ground back to a marsh or wet area where deer won't come to me, and a completely different game. But if you want to manage your private land and apply the best stands, look for something quiet, something you can sneak into. And again, what I like about that fixed position stand is I can sit, we're actually facing this way, I expect my shot down here, the mock scrapes right here, I expect to be able to turn and shoot this entire direction at least 180 degrees without ever even sitting or moving from a sitting position. And if I want, I can stand up and shoot this whole way. You almost shoot over 300 degrees pretty easily. Your tree gets in the way occasionally. But again, quiet, safe, easy to get into, stealthy access into that, and you can't go wrong. Most of all though, make sure you're safe getting into a tree. You're always better off buying quality than junk and expecting to throw away the junk every few years. And I hope you have a great hunt. The right tree stand for private land is one that allows you to get in and out of a stand and stay away from deer. Even if they had guns, you can get in and out. They don't know you're coming. Don't ever underestimate how sound travels or your ability to move around a stand and make a great shot. You have to have both, and I hope you have both this fall so that you can experience your highest potential of success. You don't ever want your tree stand getting in the way of your success. And that's why I came up with this video and our number one tree stand for actually hunting on private land. I'm excited to tell you guys about my latest web class. It's how to plant food plots, how to design your food plot program. And it covers everything. And really, there's 30 videos, over 10 hours, 11 hours of footage, workbook, hats, you know, all that stuff on top of it. I urge you to check out the link. But I cover 5 main areas: critical food plot concepts, where to plant, how to create, what to plant, and finally how to plant. It takes you through that step by step so you can make your own decisions that apply to you and build a great high quality food plot program this year, whether you have decades of experience or no experience at all.